But you're really loyal to something else, and it's kind of just what I call displaced loyalty. Amen. But let me tell you this. I do not believe I'm the only one that have experienced a case of what I call displaced loyalty. One thing I've learned is that if the purpose of something is misunderstood, abuse is inevitable.
Yes.
Amen.
Let me say that again. Let me tell you, what I've learned is that if the purpose of something is misunderstood, abuse is inevitable. So we have to really make a differentiation between favor from man and favor from God.
Amen.
There's a way we can get both, but if we got to make sure that we're coming with the right expectations and the right location, right? So let me say this. There's worldly favor and there's godly favor.
Amen.
So I'm going to share with you, I have some scriptures today. I have quite a bit of scriptures, but I'm not going to go through every one line by line, precept by precept. But I'm going to share with you today a little bit about the world's favor so you can, when you see it, you will know. And make sure that if you are operating that, you can have you make a shift so you can get the favor of God.
Amen.
So in the book of James 2, 1 through 13, it talks about don't favor the rich people over the poor people. So I have the scripture right here on my iPad, so I'm going to share a little bit of it with you. It says, my brothers and sisters, practice your faith in our glorious Lord Jesus Christ by not favoring one person over another.
Amen.
For example, two men come to you in your worship service, and one man is wearing gold rings and fine clothing. The other man, who is poor, is wearing shabby clothing. Suppose you give special attention to the man wearing fine clothing, saying to him, please, come sit up here. Sit up on the first row, right? But you say to the poor man, go stand over there. Go sit at my feet. Aren't you discriminating against people using a corrupt standard to make judgment? I don't know about you, but I've been guilty, guilty, and guilty. You know, I've been guilty of showing the favor of man or trying to receive the favor of man. Now that took us to James 2 through 4. Let me keep reading here. It says, listen, my dear brothers and sisters, didn't God choose poor people in the world to become rich in faith and receive the kingdom that he promised to those who he loved him? Yet you show no respect to the poor. Don't rich people oppress you, drag you into court? Don't they curse the good name of Jesus, the name that was to bless you? I'm on verse 8. I seem like I hear some pages turning here, trying to catch up with me. So James 2, and I'm on verse 8. You are doing right if you obey the law from the highest authority. Love your neighbor as yourself. If you favor one person over another, you're sinning. Ouch, that hurt.
Amen.
This law convicts you of being disobedient. If someone obeys all of God's laws except one, that person is guilty of breaking all of them. After all, the one who said never commit adultery is the same one who never says never commit murder. If you do not commit murder, but you commit adultery, you become a person who disobeys God's law. Two more verses here, so wait with me here. Talk and act as people who are going to be judged by the law that brings freedom. No mercy will be shown to those who show no mercy to others. Mercy triumphs over judgment.
Amen.
So, hey, this was a case where, you know, people were showing favor based on people's status. You know what?